How to Ibuki.
Yeah, that's the plan. I haven't done one of these in a really long time, so like everyone forgive me if I'm a bit like rusty on the exact format of these things. So Ibuki, we got her here. 900 health, 950 stun, pretty sure. She's got good walk speed. She's got a way to alter her jump arc, I guess. It's kind of iffy and bad because she can't attack on the way down, but it does let her move. She has a couple movement-based special moves that I'll talk about in more detail in a second. I don't know if her throw range is. I think her throw range is smaller than average, but don't quote me on that. I'm pretty sure it is, though. Forward dash, back dash, they're both pretty quick. The back dash just doesn't go very far, but it is so invincible like other back dashes. The forward dash goes pretty far and is pretty fast, so. I like the after images she still has from Street Fighter 3. I mean, 4. I guess she had them on this move in Street Fighter 3, right? To some degree. Let's just go through her real quick. Light normal stand jab is the only actual 3-frame one. It's plus 3 on hit, which means that it only combos to itself because she only has exactly one 3-frame move. I don't think she can chain it into any other. Okay, yeah, she can chain it into her other jab, but she can't chain it to short or anything like that. There's pretty much no reason to ever do stand jab, crouch jab that I can think of anyway. The main combo you'd want to do with this is probably that into, that into Rida, I guess. That into DP would be the main ones. I think in the corner you can do, into Tart combo, right? Yeah, that's a bit more friendly in corners. But you can't usually do that mid-screen unless the opponent's crouching. Oh, never mind, it just worked. I lied. I literally just tried that and it didn't work, and then I tried it again and it worked. I thought that worked, and I was all confused. I was like, what the fuck? Do you do Rida there? Anyway, I almost never do that combo anyway because crouch jab is a little bit less pushback, but crouch jab starts in 4 frames and stand jab starts in 3, so it's important to know the distinctions between the two. But that is a good 3-frame normal, and it does have a turret combo associated with it that I have just been kind of doing, and that turret combo is the beginning of like her main punish combos. It does kind of a lot of scaling, but the damage itself of the turret combo is pretty high, 108, I mean 106. Crouch Fierce by itself is only one hit of scaling and does 90, so if you're going for absolute max damage stuff, it's usually better to use Crouch Fierce instead of stand jab tar combo. But that tar combo is super good, and I'll talk more about it in a minute. Let's see here. Stand Light Kick goes the furthest of all of her light normals, and it's also plus 3, so you can start combos with it, I think. I don't know. I've never even. It's usually a combo ender because you usually just go into uppercut. Yeah, it pushes out too far. But if you've got something that's like plus 4, this is usually your main linking normal. Like I think you can do like stuff like that is a common one. That's a pretty common one. Any attack where you've got like plus frames, stand light kick is oftentimes the normal you're going into, because oftentimes you won't be able to do the jab turret combo because you'll be too far out. Again, that gets a little bit more accessible in the corner though. Let's see. Crouch Light Kick is the only low. It's also plus 3, so and you can't chain out of it, so you've got to go into stand jab. And because you're going to be getting a really far connect stand jab there, you've got to do jab into Rider or jab into Uppercut or jab into Super, which I just did on accident. In the corner, you can do jab into Tart combo, which is like the best option, but provided you're mid screen and corner crouching opponents too. But you're probably not going to hit a crouching opponent with a Crouch Light Kick because they'll probably if they're crouching, they're probably crouch blocking. But I would say something like that is probably bread and butter, or something like that. I usually like the Rida Ender because Rida gives you better Oki. Let's see here. Crouch Light Punch for the low pushback and the fact that it easily confirms her jab tart combo. Stand Light Punch because it's 3 frames, which means it combos after stuff that's only barely plus. Stand Light Kick as her main combo ender after like stuff that pushes out pretty far, and Crouch Light Kick is a low. That's pretty much her light normals in a nutshell. Think all of them are only plus 3, so you've got to link. You've either got to chain your way out or link into stand jab. Stand Medium Punch. Plus 4. It's kind of short, but it's a super good normal because it's actually plus 2 on block, and stand jab is plus 2 on block as well. just for the record. Damn, why is everyone posting that face? Did I say something wrong? It's 5 from startup. It's really fast. Goes decently far. If you get it, you can hit confirm A, stand short fairly easily. And from that stand short, you can get an uppercut or a rider or something like that. It's a really good normal for pressure because you can just use it and like walk in and use it again kind of thing, or like use it and then catch people teching throws with her other normals. It's very good to just kind of combo into and out of it. It's a very strong normal for its frame advantage. I think it has a tar combo associated with it. It's got that, right? It's like a little built-in frame trap. She can cancel it into her overhead, and a lot of people like kind of pushing reversal buttons will get caught by that overhead, or people just kind of mindlessly blocking will get caught by that overhead. And it is an overhead, and I think it has all the same properties as her other overhead. Maybe it's more plus, isn't it? Yeah, I think it gets more plus. No, how does that work? Alright, so the regular overhead is only +3 unless they're crouching, right? There's some nonsense with this. What is it? What's the nonsense? No, I think that one's always more plus. I think that's just a much better overhead. That's it. Regular overhead only combos into jab. But the Tara combo overhead combos, it's like +5 instead of +3. So if you get that overhead, you can combo to other stuff. Oh, she's got a lot of tar combos. I'm gonna miss one. I know I'm gonna miss one. Anyway, that's stay medium punch in a nutshell. It comes out really fast. It's good for getting. It's good for starting her pressure. It's easy to confirm out of on reaction. It's like the basic bread and butter like confirm combo button for her. Crouching medium punch goes really far. It looks like it would be a really sick poke, and it kind of is, but it tends to, in my experience, it's not very good at beating other medium normals. It's got a big hurtbox, and the hitbox isn't that big. It's only barely bigger than stay medium punch. Ibuki's got vaguely stubby normals here and there. You can cancel out of it into her various special moves, and it makes a pretty good, empty cancel into EX Raida, or I guess uppercut. It's really good to cancel into her kunai. You can combo into kunai at all ranges with this attack, even if you're like catching a poke. And anytime you can land a kunai, you can land like V-Trigger or EX kunai or something like that. So it ends up being like a super good empty cancel button, a super good poke button. It also comes out pretty quick. I think it's only 6 frames. So if you get counter hit stand strong, for example, you can get a link into that fairly easily. And it does cancel. So that's pretty good damage as a reaction counter hit combo. Is there more to that button? I feel like there is. There's a tar combo with this one too. Down strong towards roundhouse. I think that only combos on counter hit. No, it always combos. Oh yeah. There's actually a purpose for this one. It's really picky and stupid, but it's worth mentioning, I guess. If you do low strong into kunai, or like, you know, any setup, any kunai setup into bomb, you can do a very precise delayed low strong into towards roundhouse, and then the bomb will combo. It's like really hard to do, actually. I don't think that's optimal anymore. There used to be setups where you would use that, but I think all the setups that use that have been mostly eaten up. There's like a lot of resets that might still use it because it is kind of sneaky. But I think stand fierce into uppercut is now like the go-to ender. That's the one I usually use. We'll try and we'll get the damage comparison. That comboed. I got it. It's very delayed, low strong. What's my ender from there, though? Shit. Woo. Well, I did 281, right? It's the ender I use these days. I had 325. Alright, that tar combo, I thought it was useful for a bit. If it's useful for that at any point, it's not anymore. I'll tell you that. Ibuki's developed since then. Forget that tar combo. That tar combo's not even good. Might be good for catching people in counter hits if they like block low strong and then don't do anything. And I'm pretty sure the towards roundhouse. I don't know the frame data on that one. That's not in FAT, the best that I can tell. Hold on. I'm going to try and find it. She's got all these... Alright, what's this tar combo called? Low strong towards hard kick. Shakunage. -5. Yeah, I don't even know if that's good. I don't think it is. -5 is kind of punishable. You can maybe like poke with it, and a lot of characters can't easily punish minus five from really far out, like Birdie. His like low strong, for example, is like his 5-frame button, and it doesn't go that far, so he might only be able to punish for cross jab. I don't know why he's Birdie as an example, just as a character with like no good 5-frame normal. But like certain characters won't be able to punish that, I guess. But if they block and then get counter hit, that's like the only situation where I can think that would be really useful. Yeah, and you can get crush counters like that if people are hitting reversal buttons willy-nilly. Because towards Roundhouse is your crush counter normal. One of them. Stamineem Kick, 5 frames? Yeah, that one's pretty good. This is one of her better normals. It doesn't go super far, and it doesn't cancel, but it does have a tower combo associated with it that's kind of awesome. The Stamineem Kick, low Roundhouse, down Roundhouse. It cancels the last hit. You can't use it really to save yourself. I think it only cancels on hit, not on block. Hold on. That was the on-hit cancel. Yeah, well, they ducked it. It's very unsafe on block, but you can actually do Stamineem Kick and then react to whether the opponent blocks or gets hit, and then only finish the tower combo if they're getting hit. It's actually like you can cancel the Stamineem Kick super late, so you can just react. It's kind of difficult, especially online, but it's totally doable. So just fish with Stamineem Kick, and anytime you see it succeed, just go for the full tower combo. Even better than that is you can use it as a counter poke, because it's got a pretty good hitbox and it comes out really quick. So you can just kind of fish with this and then always do the crouch roundhouse, and then if you ever catch a normal, the crouch roundhouse will come out on its own. No need gen, my crutch roundhouse is coming out all on its own. Stamineem Kick minus one block, neutral on hit. So it's pretty riskless to push. It's a pretty nice little normal. 5-frame startup is really good. I often see like people do like Stamineem Punch. Or yeah, like fishing like that. That's a really common setup. Or like two and then that. It still goes pretty far. And even if it's outside range, that just means it'll only hit if the opponent hits a normal, and it'll probably beat their normal, so it ends up being pretty strong. Crouch Medium Kick is pretty much a poke. I'm not really aware of any other uses for it. 6-frame startup, minus 3 on block, which is pretty irrelevant for how far away it's gonna push, neutral on hit. It goes pretty far and it's a low. It doesn't cancel or anything. Guess it cancels the V trigger, but I don't think you can combo out of that. You might be able to. I just did. So I guess you could use it as a low starter. I've never seen anyone do anything like that, but you know, theoretically it works. That's a really big fishing pole to throw, like to burn your entire V trigger on a prayer. But Ibuki doesn't have a whole lot of ways of scaring the opponent into blocking low, so especially from far away. So it's good to throw out that poke occasionally just to catch people's toes, because a lot of people just kind of don't block low against Ibuki. It does have a really good hurtbox. It's very difficult to counter poke her when she's doing that. It goes pretty far and it's hard to hit. But apart from that, it's mostly just a standalone button. Stand hard punch is a really interesting normal. It goes really, really far. It's also very slow. It's like 10, 12 frame startup, and it's minus 5 on block. You can't cancel it to kunai. Kunai is a safe special move, so it's kind of safe to throw out, and then if you get that confirm, you can, you know, do stuff from it. But this button just doesn't. It goes pretty far, especially for Ibuki, and it is one of her stronger cancels, but it doesn't. That startup is just too awful. Its main use is as a combo tool, particularly after crush counters. It's like one of her best buttons to go into, because no matter the range that you get the crush counter, it'll pretty much always work, because it goes that far. And there, the speed doesn't matter as much. It's fast enough to do what it needs to do. So that's nice. It's a nice little like combo button, and I use it a lot during her V trigger combos, because it does go like the distance you need to go and the time you need to go. But apart from that, it's mostly only used as the light medium hard tower combo. It's not really used as a standalone button except as a combo ender. Or combo middler. Crouch Hard Punch is really, really tall, which makes it a pretty nice anti-air. I would say it's probably her best general anti-air. She's got a couple other options that are better depending on certain scenarios, but this one is pretty nice. The thing about it is that it cancels, which means that not only does it cleanly anti-air, well, I did it kind of late. It sucks to trade with Ibuki too, 900 health, but you can just do it early. It's really tall. If you do get it should clean anti-air like that. That was a clean anti-air. I didn't get the counter hit. And it works from a lot of ranges. Like, it works from pretty close. And it also works from pretty far away. This is probably, like, too far unless they hit a normal. But it's a pretty good general anti-air. And also it cancels, so you can do, like, cancels into, like, that was a negative edge. Hold on, let me hold the button. You can do cancels into, like, her run and then get, like, sneaky cross-under, fake cross-under kind of bullshit. Her command dash. It's usually pretty telegraphed. I think you can also just naturally anti-air with it and then dash. But, you know. Anyway, your frame advantage after that. She doesn't have an anti-air that's really faster besides the back strong. That's, like, a pretty good button, though. 9-frame startup. And it also does more damage than any other single cancel she has. So it's 90 instead of the 80 from Stand Hard Punch. Which means that if you can, it does lots and lots of damage in cancels. Like, that doesn't work on everyone, but on the characters it works on, it's the most damaging. Fuck. Crouch Hard Punch is a little bit stronger if you can help it. So, like, after, like, in a max damage combo, you'd want to be doing that instead of, like, Stand Hard Punch or Tar combo, because there's going to be a lot less scaling, and it's going to be almost the same damage as her Punch Tar combo. Let me see here. It's got a lot of blocks done. Same with her Stand Hard Punch, and that's important for, like, her shenanigans. Stand Hard Kick is also a pretty nice anti-air. The thing about Crouch Hard Punch is, while it normally does 90, if it gets an anti-air connected, it'll only do 70. And also, if the opponent empty jumps from, like, a distance that far away, they probably won't get hit by the Crouch Hard Punch because it's not that wide. So from really far away, and just kind of in general, Stand Hard Kick will always get the 90 damage that it does, but it's not as effective from up close. It doesn't have as wide a range of effectiveness that Crouch Fierce has, but the ranges where it works, it's her most reliable anti-air. It's pretty tall. What else about it? It'll catch neutral jumps, which is kind of cool. Very few anti-airs are really good at catching neutral jumps, but this button goes really far. Its other main purpose is that it's her primary crush counter normal, because it's the only crush counter normal she has that actually leaves the opponent standing. So if you want an absolute max damage combo, like, for example, if you're fighting a Ryu and you block an uppercut, Stand Hard Kick would be your ideal starter, because you can get all of your really good damage off of that. Like, let's say I've actually got a Ryu doing DPs right here. If I did, my bread and butter would probably be something along the lines of this. That was a pretty simple combo. You can make it a little bit better, I guess. I could have done Crouch Hard Punch, but that doesn't work on everyone, I think. Stand Hard Punch does work on everyone. There you go. That was a giant waste of kunai. But that's useful for that. It's useful for crush counters. Let me see here. Is there anything else it does? It's not really useful to poke. The thing about it that really sucks, so don't spam it, is that it doesn't hit crouching opponents. So you can't use it, like, to just fish with crush counters, fish for crush counters, like the way that Ryu could fish for crush counters with, like, Stand Hard Punch, or Chun-Li with Back Hard Punch or something like that. It's a bit like Cammy Stamran House, in that it's kind of slow and has a really awkward hurtbox, which means that it's basically only useful for punishing and not useful at all for fishing. I guess you can. It's not useless for fishing, but, like, it's not good. Crouch Hard Kick, this is a really good poke. It goes really far, especially for Ibuki. It comes up pretty quickly at 8 frames. It's minus 12, but at the range that you can use it, well, everyone can punish it, but the punishes you're going to be eating are not going to be as bad as, like, you know, like block DPs or anything like that. Don't just go out throwing out sweeps willy-nilly. That's a bad idea as anyone, including Ibuki, especially Ibuki, because she doesn't have the health to take all these, like, punishes. But it's not useless, is what I'm trying to say. It goes really far, and it comes out really quickly. I see a lot of Ibuki players, like, immediately after teching a throw, they'll do, like, Crush Runhouse. And for the record, Ibuki is still paid off pretty nicely for Crush Runhouse. Like, if she gets the crush counter and gets the hard knockdown, she's still got a lot of her Street Fighter 4 style shenanigans with the meaty kunai. I don't have any kunai. I'm not so good at them. I don't actually know the setups. You do them from really close, I think. You have the new Pokemon game. I have a ROM of the new Pokemon game. Sure, I got one. Anyway, you can still do shenanigans like that and have really tricky cross-ups with different kinds of jumps. Like, I think that can get a really strong one, because I think that doesn't cross up. I think the kunais in general don't usually cross up, but you can make them with, like, very, very precise. I don't know. Anyway, she's rewarded for a crush counter, but it's super risky to throw out, so this is mostly just a really specific poke that you might want to try out. It is hard normal, so it will beat, like, medium normals instead of trading, and light normals instead of trading. Oh, I should text back my friend. I just realized he texted me, and I just realized he's at work, so, like, he might be waiting on seeing... Okay, he didn't. Waiting on seeing if I could give him a ride. Alright, what's now? So that's all our grounded normals. I guess command normals. We got the slide. This is pretty much like it is in Street Fighter 4, with one big difference. The big difference is the fact that there's, input leniency. So you can always get the first frame buttons after the slide. On absolute max range, I think it's plus 4. So if you're absolutely max range, you can combo a Sandlight Kick. And that's pretty good, because you can get, like, Rider or whatever. If you're not quite... If you're absolutely max range, you can't combo Sand Jab, because it's too far away. Which is would make it an easier link. But if you're, like, one frame shy of max range, you can combo Sand Jab, because it goes from plus 4 to plus 3. But plus 3 is still enough for Jab. So there's, like, two different ranges where it can hit, where one of them you can only get Jab, and the other one you can only get Short. It's kind of stupid. If you do it meaty, you can get Jab or Short, because it'd be closer. And it's still safe if you do it meaty. But, like, you know, it's not a super good mix-up. It's just a meaty low. You could do better with a meaty low, just with low short. And then if you get a counter hit, it's quite easy to link out of stand like a con reaction. But it's fairly easy when you get a max range one. It's like, oh, I got... That's the max range one. You can just react when you get, like, a very well-spaced one and then decide to combo out of it. I got the max range one. That was pretty good, but I missed the link. But, like, something. You could do something like that. I'm still not so hot at Ibuki, am I? That was, like, pixel close. It works, trust me, okay? Ah, I can't judge this. Good Ibuki players will be good at this. It still goes under fireballs, so it's still a very good fireball counter. It's probably her best fireball counter, because she lost some other stuff that was good against fireballs, like Neckbreaker. That's the sweet. What's the fireball? Even if you're not even hitting the opponent, I did it super early on purpose. Even if you do it super early, even if you don't hit the opponent, okay, not super early. I was talking about. Even if you don't hit the opponent, it can still cleanly go under fireballs. I don't know the timing on this shit. This is a slow fireball, so this is as hard as it gets, unless it's like a good sonic boom. It can go under nearly every fireball in the game, because I think it... I don't know if it actually low profiles or if it's fireball invincible. I'm pretty sure it just low profiles, but there's no, like, low fireball right now, so that's not a huge deal. Except kunai. Should get another, Ibuki. Romailer says, slide is ass for fireballs, it's inconsistent. It's a lot more consistent if you manage to hit the opponent, but the ranges where that works are very narrow. It's, like, right around here. You can react to a fireball and slide. And it's really good in those ranges. That's, like, the range where you really want to be looking for it. Going under fireballs from this far out is not very useful, because the opponent can potentially, like, do something to you, especially if it's a slow fireball and they follow it in. And if you're closer, then you're not going to be able to react in time, because it doesn't get its fireball invincibility from frame one. Oh yeah, Jerry's fireball. I forgot about that one. But she's got the slide, and you can combo out of it from max range, and it still goes under fireballs. You can't do anything from it unless you get a really far one. You can't V-trigger cancel it or anything like that. What else? Back medium punch, I guess. Let me get all of her. Back medium punch, forward medium kick, forward hard kick. Alright. Back medium punch, pretty interesting normal. Does a few things, very specific things. It's really, really good at those specific things. What's the speed on this guy? Is this Sazon? No. This is Agumon. Yeah, 7 frame startup, plus 4 on hit, minus 1 on block. Alright, so the interesting thing about this normal is it's 2 hits, and the first hit causes struggle state on airborne opponents, and the second one causes an air reset on airborne opponents. So if you're doing like an anti-air, she had these in Street Fighter 4 as well, but it's not as good in this game because it's not as far. It's not as upper body invincible as it was in Street Fighter 4, so it's a lot harder to do. But you can get like clean. Wow, I got a really early one. You can just let it rock as an anti-air, and it's okay. It's not upper body invincible anymore, or it is, but like less. So it's easier. There it is. It's easier to get counter hit with a bat jump in, which will kill you if you're Ibuki. But with precise timing, you can always get that kind of hit where it gets both hits, and you can actually cancel the first hit. And if you cancel the first hit, you can keep the juggle state from the first hit. So you could do something like that, for example. Kind of looks like our Street Fighter 4 style anti-airs. There's a few other things you can do with that. Like you can get kunai releases and stuff. That's pretty useless. It also has juggle potential in scenarios where you need to juggle the opponent. Let me see if I can think of a pretty good example. I saw one. What was the setup? It was like a kunai into bomb, and then. Okay, that might have been it. And then it was a cross under. Oh man, I've never done this before in my life. Alright, that into kunai. Into bomb. And then another target combo. Walk in into another target combo. And then it was a dash like that. And the bomb hits as a cross up in that scenario. You like reset and the opponent recovers, but then you're on the other side, so the bomb hits from behind. And then when the bomb hits from behind like that, you do the back medium punch immediately and it hits them before they can fly into the air. And the back medium punch from that, you can combo into the dash. Or rather, cancel into the dash. And you do the second hit for that one, or rather, it combos the second hit. And then from that dash, you're suddenly on the other side again. It's kind of like a little sneaky double cross up you can do after bomb. That's one I've seen, but like there's other stuff you can do. Another good example is when you get like a juggle on a cornered opponent. This combos. What's the exact setup? That one's the okay. It's the free juggle state. It's the kunai release, right? That one's like only useful. Yeah, that one's only useful for like closing out rounds, but it's kind of cool. Well, there's a bunch of stuff you can do with it. If you get the reset on a cornered opponent, like I was just trying there, but. If you get the reset on a cornered opponent, you can do a walk under, I think. Whoa. There's some setup where you can. Yeah, you can do stuff like that. I was pretty late on my jab strong fierce when I reacted, but like with good timing, that can be very ambiguous whether you cross under or not. That's it. That's one of the ones I was thinking of. Back medium punch, heavy dash, kunai, Rida or DP. That's one of her juggles she can do. Let me show that as an anti-air. There's a couple scenarios where you can land it, but anti-air will be the easiest to show off. Let me get out of the corner. I have very little experience with this one. Whoa, that works with an anti-air, right? No, I'm not so sure. I've seen it in combos. Yeah, I got a jab. Ugh, this is gonna be freaky. The timing on this, I'm not so good with. I only play Ibuki very casually. Oh, what the fuck? I missed my cancel. Oh, that was it too. I was just a little late. Forward hard kick, crush counter. That's a good one. That's one of the ones I see. The other one's kunai release. Why did I not start with that? Ibuki, please. What the fuck? My motions suck. Let me do light. Light's faster. Isn't it? Think it is. I'm bad. I think DP might be easier. I think DP starts in like 4 or 5 frames. I think 5. There you go. I did DP. Okay. Have to do DP. Confirmed. Have to do DP there. That one was not a run out. That one just doesn't work. From the kunai release, you can do it too. Like, that one might be corner only. I'll try it mid screen just to see. Whoa. Yeah, I think that's corner only. Yeah. That's like an example, like Ender from her bread and butter combos. I did the combo I'm more used to doing.
Okay, go.
This is like an example, like super max. Like post Izzy Ender. Fuck. My natural motion to back. Oh, you have to do a little walk in there, don't you? Oh my god, I'm so bad at this crap. Ugh. Well, that works anyway. You'll have to take my word for it. Let's see here. What did I get distracted on? Oh yeah, back medium punch. First of all, causes juggle state on airborne opponents, so you can do neat juggles with it. Second, it's not too bad on block. And it hit confirms her stand light kick, so you can use it in place of stand medium punch, although generally you'll want to use stand medium punch. But you can hit confirm out of it, and I occasionally see Ibukis do that. I don't know what the advantages and disadvantages are of that, because it is, like, I don't know, it's not as plus on block as medium punch is. But if you do get it, you can just, you know, combo out of it. There's something else it did. Anti-air, juggle tool, combo like a combo starter. I don't know. It's not part of a tar combo, is it? Oh shit, I think it is part of a tar combo. No, it was. Street Fighter 4. Not in this game, right? Not in this game. Alright, cool. Let's see here. What's next? Towards tar kick? Alright, so this is a really nice little poke. It's not super risky. I think it's a little smidge minus at minus two. Is that this one? Bonsho Gary, Kabu, Kobeku Daki. Which one's this? I didn't talk about overhead either. All right, so the overhead is minus two plus three. That makes sense because it's plus three. This one is minus three plus two. Yeah, right. So minus three on block, but from the ranges, that means it's only punishable by lights and like Geef Super and shit like that. And from the ranges you're going to be using it, hopefully you won't be hit. Lights won't reach you. It is a crush counter normal. Normally it's like not too bad to land anyway at like plus two, and it does have some like airborne frames, like it looks like it does. But usually you can't really use that to go over stuff like as well as you would think, because it's got kind of a long startup. And I think it doesn't get the airborne frames until it's pretty much already out. I think you can also use it to corpse hop to some degree, but you can also use towards medium kick to corpse hop, and I think neither of those are super useful in this game. There's some setup where like the corpse hop is guaranteed. It might be good after... I swear I've seen people do that. Is it Ryu? Or is it my timing? There we go. It's my timing. You can use that for some kind of bomb setups, but I don't know the bomb setups, but I've seen... I know that they exist. Oh, there's so many bomb setups, I don't know any of them. I know some. Anyway, this is a super good little poke, because it is a hard normal, and it does go pretty far for Ibuki. And if you do happen to get the crush counter with it, it's a really good counter poke too, because it's got kind of a long active period, and it's a hard normal, so it does beat medium and light normals clean. If you get it as a counter poke, you've pretty much got to go into EX Rida, because nothing else will reach. EX Rida hits really quickly and goes really far. But if you get it at like its max range, if you get it any place where it's not a counter poke, like any place where it naturally connects, you can combo a hard uppercut pretty easily. Or a super. Or I feel like some other things. I think kunai release. But super and uppercut, generally normal ones. If you get it from pretty close, you can get a regular Rida. And regular Rida is nice because you get Godoki. But from afar, you've got to do hard uppercut, and from really far, like as a counter poke, you've got to do EX Rida. But usually uppercuts, like the Ender that I'm fishing for, or like Rida if I'm pretty close, but I don't usually do it from pretty close. But it's a really good poke, and if you get the crush counter, it's like relatively safe, and if you get the crush counter, you can just reaction combo out of it, and the combo does pretty good damage. So overall, it's like a fairly lowish risk, high reward attack. But it's pretty standalone. It doesn't V-trigger cancel, or like it doesn't have any combos associated with it besides the crush counter combos I just did. Oh, and this is one of the ones where you can do that, as we were just talking about earlier. There's the non-kunai version if you're like out of kunai. I guess the overhead. The overhead's +3, -2 on block, so it's safe. It's ridiculously slow, but it's somewhat balanced by the fact that it actually jumps. Like, it's a real jump. Ibuki's immune to throws, and she's immune to lows for pretty much the whole animation after she gets off the ground. Actually getting the combos out of this thing is kind of a pain. Counter hit, I think it's +5, so you can combo stand medium kick. But generally, you're only +3. So you've got a combo stand jab, and that's a really far jab. You can't do the tar combo. So you've got to do, like, stand jab into uppercut, or stand jab into Raida. Stand jab into hard uppercut. Stand jab into hard uppercut, but you don't drop the combo. Generally, you've got to do, like, jab into Raida or something like that if you don't get the counter hit. The only exception, as I mentioned, is if the opponent's cornered, then the tar combo works because it's a bit more accessible in the corner. Having an overhead you can combo out of is pretty strong, but this overhead is just so slow, like, anyone can react to it. If they're dedicated to blocking, it's almost impossible to land. But the thing about it is that because it's got all this invincibility and this kind of weird timing to it, and the fact that it goes pretty far, it's fairly easy to counterpoke people or like catch them unaware. But it's still, I would call it, it's a really interesting overhead. I would call it kind of a bad overhead, but it's interesting. It doesn't work the way that a normal overhead works. It doesn't work on the same, like, it's not an overhead for catching people who are trying to block low too hard. It's an overhead for like kind of counter hit setups, I guess. It's pretty slow, though. It's like a really slow overhead. I should have its speed in here somewhere. 28 frame startup. Yeah, that's like an hour. It's safe, too. It's a safe overhead. Most overheads in this game are like -4, -6, but this one's -2. So only don't use it on Zangief Super. That's pretty much all our grounded normals, right? Pretty much. I think we've hit all of them. I didn't talk about some of the tar combos. Jab strong fierce, jab strong short. That's an important one that I didn't mention at all. So the jab strong fierce tar combo is super nice in terms of like damage and combo options. Ibuki can do pretty much everything she wants to do when she lands it. But the thing about it is, even though this is like goes, even though it starts from a 3-frame normal, and even though it works on crouching opponents, and you know, like everything good about jab strong fierce in this game compared to previous games, it's super unsafe if they block it. And actually, you can't. Even though it cancels into kunai on hit, it actually won't cancel at all on block. It just loses cancelability. So it's really easy for the opponent. The only exception is V-trigger. So, and I think even that's quite punishable. Like, if you just mash DP there, I think I would get hit. You can't just throw it out willy-nilly. But the thing about this tar combo is there's another tar combo with the same two starting normals. And this one combos into absolutely nothing. I guess you could use it as like a poke string if you wanted to. But its main purpose is, if you see yourself doing jab strong fierce, you can fish with jab strong. And if you see it's hitting, you can do jab strong fierce into your full combo. And if you see that it's being blocked, you can do jab strong short. Because the short is safe. It's not her normal short. But it's like, if they block it, it's still totally safe. So it's like a little, it's like a salvage star combo. It's like a tar combo to save you if you're screwing up. And it also allows you to like use the jab strong as a hit confirm. It allows you to use your max damage combo as a hit confirm. But you've got to be on point with your reactions because you don't have a whole lot of time to react to whether the opponent's hitting or being blocked by the time you need to do your third normal. No, you don't fish like that. You fish like, you just have to use one or the other. You never just do jab strong because the jab strong is unsafe. But jab strong short is safe, so you just react between those two on an opponent who's blocking or not. But it lets you use, the fact that she has that means that you can kind of effectively use jab strong fierce as a, or you can use jab strong and confirm fierce and do her like max damage combos, or you can just use that and get your safe combos. You can just, it's like a little branching ender for whether you want to be safe or high damage, and you can just react to which one you want. But there's not much use to it besides being safe. Otherwise, you just use this Jeff Strong Fierce. This one I talked about, right? Off of the Stay Medium Kick. This is the sweep into Stamron House. I'd actually really love a 2-bar V-trigger for this bitch. Low strong towards hard kick. Strong into towards medium kick. Alright, her air-tar combos. So she's got two. they're both kind of hard to use. This should theoretically work on... This used to work on, like... I don't know a good purpose for the jab forward tar combo in this game. It doesn't seem to work very well on grounded opponents. On airborne opponents, it normally air resets before it can hit. But if you're doing the command jump, you can get both. But if you're doing command jump, you can just do that one. I guess the reason is that it doesn't slam, right? So you can do that and then do like some kind of sneaky cross under kind of thing, maybe. After like bomb combos. I've never even tried that, to be honest. But I'm gonna try it right now. I did it really, really, really early. No, that doesn't look like you have enough time to cross under. Maybe if I did it super late, but it's usually easier if you do it early. I don't know. I don't think you can get some kind of sneaky cross up from that. The slam is usually good. I'll take the slam. The other one is hard punch, hard kick, and that one's also pretty much impossible to get on grounded opponents. I guess you could do it like from a command jump because you fall slower for that. Yeah, there you go. I did it. I did one. anyway, she's got this other one, hard punch, hard kick, which is also too slow to work on grounded opponents usually. But from the command jump, you have enough time to do it, and that's like her max damage combo starter. If you've got like a dizzy opponent or something like that. Easier on some characters than others. It depends on how tall they are. You'll have a hard time doing it on Cammy. You'll never ever fuck it up if you're doing it on Zangief. Minus on hit, is it? Anyway, that's useful for her like bomb combos. I've been doing it periodically. I've been trying to do it periodically. How does it work for second bomb? Not like that. There you go. That's like her max damage ender from first bomb if you don't want the second bomb reset. But it also doesn't have the greatest Oki in the universe, so a lot of people just end with Raidas. There's a lot of different ways to play out your bomb combos. I've been doing that one, but like, there's a lot. I'll show off some others when I talk about V-Trigger. But it's useful for it's an ender for some of her tar combos, and it's also a starter for her like punish combos. But apart from that, it's not a super useful tar combo because if you hit an airborne opponent with it, they'll just get air reset before their hard kick can connect. I didn't mention this, but I feel like it's definitely absolutely 100% worth mentioning. But she has an air throw. FOs are not as good in this game as they were in Street Fighter 4. I feel like they're not as tall up or down. And also, like, the height that you go, like, you jump really high really fast and come down really fast in this game. So you're, like, jumping higher, but, like, the jumps take about the same amount of time. But because of that, if two people jump at, like, relatively different times, or, like, pretty much the same time, there's less time they're, like, at the same height. There's something going on like that, but, like, air throws are kind of harder to land. You can use it as like a jump back tech, but it really doesn't have enough range to be a good anti-air from up close. You can use it as a jump forward anti-air, but it's a little bit more risky. But like, it's a good anti-air if they're jumping from super close, I guess. Usually you won't do anything like that. But you can, if you're expecting a jump, or if you react to a jump really quickly, you can jump in air throw them, and it does better damage than most of her anti-airs. And also like keeps the same screen position. Or rather, keeps the same side of the screen. But she does have an air throw. Just want to bring that up. And it's faster than most other air attacks too, but it doesn't go nearly as far as like a jump hard kick will, so even if it's faster, like you still have to get next to them. I've pretty much covered all of her command normals and stuff, right? Air normals, I guess. I didn't cover those. Jump jab, I guess it's good as an air to air. I never ever see anyone use it. Jump short is kinda cool. I think it can cross up, but more importantly, it's an overhead. So you can do some sneaky stuff with bombs on like the opponent's like four stand frames, where I don't know why I did that bomb and not like this bomb. I don't know how long this takes to explode. Anyway, you can catch people with certain setups on their four stand frames with the jump back short, and then the bomb combos from the jump back short, and you can do some cool stuff with that. There's some resets involving that with, like, the forward bomb. You can use it to close out rounds with, like, you know, just the fact that it's an instant overhead and the fact that you can do it relatively safely from a jump back. I think it requires fuzzy guard. It's not a super tall instant overhead. So it works on everyone, but you need to force them to block an air normal first. But it's pretty good. It's a pretty good instant overhead as they go, and it is a cross up, and it has less block stun than a jump medium kick cross up. So you can use it as like a throw reset fairly easily. I was too fast. There you go. Jump medium kick is a general cross up. It's pretty wide. It's one of the wider cross ups in the game, so you can pretty easily get the cross up attacks. It's pretty much your go-to normal if you're jumping over the opponent. It's also pretty far forward, which is nice. I think it goes down the most of all your air normals, which is important, of course, if you want to hit the opponent as soon as possible, like if it's re-recovering from a fireball or something like that. Jump strong, I've literally never seen anyone use. Might be a good air-to-air. Jump heavy punch is like oftentimes the starter people use. Jump heavy kick, it's pretty much whichever one you want to use, but I more oftentimes see people use jump heavy punch and jump heavy kick. I don't know if it actually goes down more, if it's just they don't like the delay of jump heavy kick because it comes out kind of slow. But this is a better air-to-air if you're going for like your damage air-to-airs. This is a better one just because it comes out faster, and it's like a good starter for like your regular jumping combos, and jump hard kick is also a good starter for your regular jumping combos, so basically pick your poison between those two. But anyway, she's got a cross-up, she's got an instant overhead, and then she's got, like, normal starters. What now? I guess special moves, right? Not that much more to talk about. I could talk about a V-skill. I'll talk about that before the trigger. Yeah, let's talk about special moves. Alright, we got a lot, don't we? Alright, let's get started. Kasumigake. I've been using this special move a lot. It's a command dash. The medium one goes through the opponent, the light one does not go through the opponent. The light one resolves a lot faster, the medium one is kind of slower. They're really useful for moving. There are a lot of scenarios where you get like a knockdown and you can just do one guaranteed and it'll help you stay close to the opponent. They're really useful for tricks. Like if I do, like let's say I get a punish combo and I do like stand hard kick as like the starter for my crush counter, and then I do stand hard punch on hit, and then I do the medium one. I think that gets blown up by reversal normals, but pretty much anyone will not be doing reversal normals there. Pretty much a lot of stuff is like a lot easier to do on hit than on block. You could still do this on block, depending on how dedicated the opponent is to blocking. But you could do, like, let's say, stand heavy punch into command dash, medium command dash, and then jab strong. And if you see them blocking, you can do the short, and if you see them getting hit, you can do the fierce and your full combo. But you can do, you can use that as like a cross up because the opponent recovers and you're on a new side. You can get them because they're not expecting the block in that direction. But it has a lot of recovery. So if the opponent just hits like they've Ryuto's like reversal low strong or something like that, it'll just hit me. I won't be able to block. It's got a lot of recovery. So it's not easy to. It's like most of the other run style attacks in this game, like Laura's V skill cancels and Ken's V skill cancels. It's like, it's good for catching people unaware, but it's very punishable if they're just doing reversal stuff. Like, even non-reversal, like just reversal attacks, just reversal normals. The light one resolves a lot faster, but it will never ever cross up, so you can still use it. I think it can be safe on, like, a stand fierce on hit into whatever. You can use it as a reset, I guess, just to stay near the opponent if you want to, like, go for a throw reset instead of completing your combo. I rarely see people do that. It is useful for staying in if you're doing, like, when I was doing the back strong combos, I was using the light one. It resolves the fastest, so it's important. If you want one that just resolves as fast as possible, use the light one. But the light one can't cross up, and the medium one will always cross up when inside a certain range. So if you're doing one or the other, it can be kind of hard to react to which one it is at certain ranges. And it's like, if Ibuki does this from here, that crosses up. But if she does this from here, it's like it doesn't cross up. It's just an additional layer of you need to react to which side Ibuki's on if she's doing the resets. And it's a little bit safer. I think she's counter hit if she's hit out of these, so you have to be really, really careful about using them because he does not have that good health. The hard one is really unique. It jumps, and that jump is a little bit different from her normal jump. For one, her tar combos, they don't reset anymore, they suddenly juggle. And for two, she falls a lot slower than normal. She's also got a very unique arc, and there's some interesting things you can do with that unique arc. Like, if you've got an opponent in the corner, there's a timing you can use with jump medium kick where it crosses up and lands on the same side. Like, Chun-Li's V-Skill has the same deal. Pretty much no one ever blocks these. No one ever blocks these. These are like 100% success rate. The only problem is if the opponent knows it's going to be a cross-up. Like, if he just has that feeling, he can just, like, walk forward, and he'll block it because it's a cross-up, and he'll actually walk under you. But in scenarios where the opponent can't get out, like if they didn't quick stand, or if it's, like, a hard knockdown sweep or something like that, if you do this, in situations where it's guaranteed, you can actually have it. Like, I just did it there. This is super, super difficult to get out of. It's, like, a really annoying setup. And if you're just a little bit later with it, you actually will get the cross-up, too, so it ends up being, like, a true mix-up. Pretty much a true mix-up. I'm trying to do it late now. There we go. It's like crazy difficult to get out of that. The problem is you don't get that many setups for it. but that's just one example of like the kind of weird jump arc. I've seen some other stuff too. Like I've seen what's the one? It's hard kick. I've seen this one. This one's pretty neat. It must have been. Hold on. Yeah, it must have been medium kick, because he did the hard kick for the... Yeah, so I saw a guy do this one time. I saw him do that. So what you can do is you can do that command jump and then go for the cross-up. And that's, like, fairly easy to do. But with that kunai release, that kunai ikinaga, you actually won't cross-up from that same jump arc that leads to a cross-up. So that's like, you can just anti-air that. But that's going to catch a lot of people off guard. A lot of people aren't going to be ready to block that in that direction. That's, like, really tricky. But in order to even do that, you need to have several kunai, because just having one kunai, the kunai won't go in the right direction. Actually, it did. Well, it won't do any damage anyway. Usually the kunai don't work like that. Or, I mean, I don't know. I guess it always keeps the most convenient kunai first. Anyway, I don't think you can get anything out of that. But it is a nice little sneaky way to close out a round. Ibuki has a lot of nice little sneaky ways to close out a round. It's like her character in a nutshell. Is there anything else about Command Dash? There's like a lot. There's no EX version. I feel like I should mention that right now. There's like a lot about this move, and most of it's like really technical. It's a really technical special move. Let's talk about another one. Let's talk about Raida. Are the Raidas different speeds? I swear they were. They're different damages, and they're different Oki. Okay, they're all the same speed. They're 7. It's different damage and different Oki. So the light one leaves you really close to the opponent, which is better, but only does 100 damage and 200 stun. Hard one leaves you really far away from the opponent, but does 120 damage. They're literally identical if you've got a cornered opponent. You're going to have exactly the same Oki. So always do the hard one on a cornered opponent. But the light one mid-screen, usually that Oki, that better Oki, is better than the hard one's damage. Like, the 20 extra damage is usually not worth it. You usually want to stay in close to the opponent. I think you can use a Raida, even if they quickstand. I think you can recover a kunai, right? Where's recovery? That didn't... Well, that looked a little... That looked like he could punish it if he was really on his game. Hard one, you can definitely recover a kunai. Hard one, it's, like, really hard to stop Ibuki from getting a kunai back. So if you're, like, desperate for kunai, hard one's pretty good. The longest kunai reload time is probably an EX kunai or air EX kunai where you deliberately don't do the ender. You can get like pretty much 4 or 5 there guaranteed if you hit the opponent with some really long setup like that. That was with quickstand. I just got 4 back. EX kunai are really good for restoring your kunai if that's a big issue. There's a couple others. I think super lets you get a few kunai back too. But mostly just hard Raida on a non-cornered opponent or EX kunai into no follow-up. And just use the time to get your kunai back. Kunai are pretty good too, so it's like worth knowing those setups. But to be honest, like if you're just careful with your kunai, you're probably not even going to go through the 6 in any given round. It's good to stay healthy with the kunai though, because the kunai is like it's one of the better special moves in the game. Anyway, Raida's super unsafe on block. It's minus 12 on block, so you can't just do it willy-nilly. Most special moves in this game are unsafe. It's a decent ender when it comes to enders. Like, compared to her, let's say I'm doing the hard one, does 190 after the tar combo, compared to my hard uppercut, was also 190. So it's The hard one does the same damage as all our uppercuts. But the light one has, like, only slightly less damage and much better Oki. So I just lost 14 damage to do that. So it's usually the Ender people use as Ibuki. They do light, Raida. It's a good way to close out our combos. And it also, it's pretty fast. It combos even from lights. That's a combo. Combos are a little weird to do because it's a half circle cancel, but it's not too hard to get used to. Anyway, the EX one is super special. It combos, it goes really, really far. And I think it's still really unsafe. Minus 11. It's still really unsafe, but you can use it to catch the opponent in certain juggles. These Raidas, even though they're like kind of hit grabs, they're not actual grabs, they're hits with animations. But even though they're like kind of hit grabs, they still hit the bomb. So if your Raida bumps the bomb, what's the setup? I want my second bomb. Infinite, right? Now I have infinite bomb, infinite second bomb. All right, so what's this? Something like that, right? Yeah, that's it. There's setups where you can Raida the opponent into a bomb blast and then command dash and then Raida the opponent again. That's not an EX Kunai, is it? Bomb's a free juggle state. You gotta be pretty close for that one. Where are my EXs? I'm full of spirit. Medium. There you go. Another good example. Sample combo. Sample second bomb combo. Using Raida to bump people into the bomb. And you can also, like, hit the opponent into the bomb, if this makes any sense. You can hit the bomb with the Raida. And that will throw the opponent... That can throw the opponent into it. Sometimes you want to reposition the bomb. That's one of her setups. I think the DP one is usually better, though. But the DP one... The thing about the DP one... I should talk about this one. I talk about B-Trigger. The thing about the DP setup is that you... Oh, never mind. What is it? What is it about the DP setup? Fuck, I'll talk about that when I talk about V-Trigger. DP setup's usually better, I think. I talked about Raida. There's not much to it. It's just a combo ender. And from that combo ender, you can get like a guaranteed dash in or guaranteed kunai pull out or stuff like that. It's got nice... very delayed startup wake up for the opponent, which lets you get lots of stuff off in that meantime, even like meaty pressure, I guess, from like jumps and whatever. Uppercut. There's not a whole lot to say about uppercut. Uppercut's really tall, so you can anti-air with it. I'm not gonna say it's good because it has no invincibility whatsoever. But it is really tall, so if you do it early, it's like a super consistent anti-air, and it also works from really close if you're doing it like that. And I think even from like a very, very high connect, you might even be able to do something there. Don't quote me. Maybe two. Maybe two uppercuts. That'd be really cool. Anyway, you'd never use it like that, but you could use it like an anti-air is the point. You could use the light one as a really early anti-air. They're all the same damage. The only difference, and I think they're all the same startup. The only difference is that, hold on. Kazekiri. 3-4-5. The light one's fast. That's 3 frames. Wait, no one told me. Timeout. Oh my god, that combo. This is 3 frames? Jesus Christ, I learned something. Anyway, the light one is... It doesn't move very far forward, and the hard one moves really far forward. So usually in combos, you want the hard one, just because it gets all the hits more consistently and keeps you a little bit closer to the opponent. And I guess the light one's better if they're like above your head jumping in or something like that, and also the fact that it, you know... starts up really fast. Even knowing that it starts in 3 frames, like, unless you're getting certain 3 frame punishes where stand jab is out of range, I can't say that being a particularly good, a big deal. I'm guessing you need to be about the same range as stand jab anyway, just to get the 3 frame punish, to get it hit on the first frame. Because if you get like 2 hits only, you're missing the first hit, which is the 3 frame one. I'm pretty sure all of these are crush counter punish, right? Definitely the EX one. We'll talk about the EX one right now. The EX one is neat. It's invincible. Unfortunately, it has a fuck ton of forward motion, which makes it not a very good anti-air. You've got to be... It'll typically go under the opponent, is the problem. Like, even if you do it pretty late, it'll typically go under the opponent from any range that people usually jump. It's a pretty good anti-air if they're really far out. I guess it's invincible. But just the fact that it goes so far forward is pretty lame. Not Crush kind of punishable? Okay. Only the X one. That's good. That's good. That's good. So the EX one has, like, this really long... It's got invincibility, like, a lot of invincibility, but the problem is it, if it's blocked, it's pretty much your ass on a silver platter. If it's not blocked, you can actually combo out of it with an EX kunai, and that's usually useless, although I did show off earlier. It's good if you want to reload a bunch of kunai. And also, if you're closing out a round, this is pretty much your max damage ender, but you'll never see this, but it does work. After throwing the EX kunai, you can actually start charging with Light Punch and do a kunai Ikinaga, and that combos from the bomb there. And that's like our max damage ender. I'm not so good at this. I'd like never ever practice this. Like that. So if you've got like a fair amount of kunai, you can actually get a ton of damage right at the end there. And a lot of people like will like get near miss kills on their combos, not realizing that they can burn all of their kunai and also an additional bar to actually close out the round. You won't see that very often, but I just wanted to let everyone know that it's possible. I think you can do... There's no regular kunai cancel, right? It's only EX. And I don't think there's any meaningful way to use non-EX kunai. Yeah. Does that work in the corner? I feel like there's something it does. I feel like it's not utterly useless. Maybe it is utterly useless. I think you've just got to use the EX, and there's nothing else you can do there. Well, whatever. You can combo EX kunai, EX air kunai, after an EX DP. There you go. Costs a kunai, costs a bunch of bar, but it is a combo from an invincible attack that does fairly good damage. So that's kind of a big deal. Minus 27 for normal Kazukiri, minus 31 for EX Kazukiri. That's pretty bad. Airborne kunai. Street Fighter V's engine was not kind to Ibuki. She cannot throw kunai on neutral jumps, she cannot throw kunai on back jumps, which means your kunai tosses are very, very specific. A kunai toss can beat an anti-air normal, like if you're fighting like a birdie and he does like anti-air strong, low strong. Kunai will usually just beat it clean. The problem is after you do that jump, and after you throw that kunai, you'll be so minus that birdie will be able to still punish you. So regular jump in kunai is usually meaty only. And it's okay if it's meaty. Like, if you've actually got the time, if the opponent doesn't quicksand or something like that, you can actually do, like, the jump in kunai and get, like, the fake cross-ups or whatever, or do the jump in medium kick and get the real cross-ups. You've still got that kind of little semi-mix-up, but the fact that everyone quicksands everything in this game means that you won't have many opportunities to do that, and you have no crush counter. You have no hard knockdowns except crush counter sweep, which is really unsafe. Oh, yeah, you can also... Kunai Ikinaga, you can do jumping backwards or neutral jumping. That's like its own special move. I'll talk about kunai Ikinaga in a second. Air EX kunai is an entirely different matter, though. Air EX kunai is actually super awesome. You only have one arc, I'm pretty sure. Which is unfortunate, because that means you can't jump from super close and like get that bomb all the time. But at ranges where that bomb works, it will beat the opponent's anti-air normals, or whatever anti-air they're going for. It'll beat most anti-airs. It might not beat like Ryu medium DP or something, but it'll definitely beat like a Bison Crutch Fierce or something like that. It'll beat most anti-air normals and a lot of anti-air like other stuff. And then after you land it, it's like it launches the opponent, so you can do like a dash in Raida or something like that. You can get like a combo or like a dash in, I don't know. I guess dash in Raida. You can't combo super here because it's EX. You can get like a kunai Ikinaga, I think, too. Or like some kind of sneaky nonsense. Maybe not that kind of sneaky nonsense. That was an accident. Overrolling. There you go, sneaky nonsense. I was a bit late. Tiger Knee EX Kunai is... Yeah, you can do it super low to the ground. I did it. That was not it. If you're really low... The problem is the effectiveness, the range of effect. Even though you can, like... It's really good to be able to do it and, like, hit an opponent from this close. I'm not actually very good at the actual Tiger Knee motion. If you just do it low to the ground, from up close, the bomb will often miss. But like from ranges like here, it's like a really good pressure tool that gets you close. And the thing about the bomb is even if they block this, as long as the bomb explosion is hitting, it's really plus. It's like crazy plus. It like gets you a free approach. And from that free approach, like you can get like a walk-in delayed strong or like a walk-in throw or a walk-in walk-out, something like that. Jump cancelable normals. I don't think so. I think they removed those. She's got the command jump now, so you can do that, but Ibuki doesn't have a high jump anymore, so I'm pretty sure jump cancelable attacks are pretty much gone. Let me see here. What else about air EX kunai? It's basically just a fuck you to characters with anti-air normals. It makes them have to second guess every single anti-air they do. The problem is you're staking a kunai and an EX on it. So it's not... It's a lot. It's not as... You're guessing that the opponent's going to try for the anti-air so that you can get, like, you know, your punish on it. But it is pretty... It's a really good tool. It's one of Ibuki's most unique tools. It's really strong. Grounded kunai. Unfortunately, it's not... You got three different ranges. The hard one is usually the best. I don't think there's particularly many reasons to use the light one or the medium one. It might be a little bit more plus frames at certain ranges. I don't know. Honestly, I never see it. It combos from crouch jab, but not stand jab or stand short. So usually you won't really see it. It's kind of useful. I didn't mention that at all. But you can do like light normal confirms like that. And any situation where you can get a kunai, you can get a bomb. Or like, I think an EX kunai too, right? Yeah. Kunai by itself is not crazy good. It's pretty good. It's a safe special move, and safe special moves are always really awesome. And it doesn't go through fireballs. Let me show off it not going through a fireball. But it's worth noting that it has a very low arc, which means that you can often catch people throwing fireballs. Or, like, from very, very far away, you can hit people's toes as the kunai goes under the fireball. So it's a fairly good, like, full-screen tool. Or just it gives her full-screen presence, which is really nice. The main problem with them is you have a finite amount of them. Otherwise, this would be the most spammable special move in the entire game. But you've only got six. And it's a super good, like just fishing tool. Because the thing about it is you can cancel into V-trigger on reaction to a successful one. I can just do low strong into kunai, which is a nice little string anyway. It's only minus two. But any time I see that work, I can just throw a bomb. And then I can just get a ton of damage from that bomb. That's super rewarding. Or even if I was like doing certain other enders, I could throw another bomb, like if I did that ender with the second bomb, or that ender with second bomb. You can get like a mix-up on the opponent. Anyway, it's like a super good... The regular kunai is like a super good fishing pole. If you see the opponent, like... is there anything... That doesn't work from that far away. That's what I thought. That one did work. Does that work? Okay, I thought that didn't work, and I got really scared that it did. I was like, oh shit, I need to be using that all the time. Yeah, it's just that kunai doesn't go far enough fast enough. Light and hard. Yeah, it's only. Fuck. It's only that one that combos and it doesn't get the bomb. Anyway, before I rudely interrupted myself, Grand Kunai is super safe to just kind of throw out. It goes really, really, really far. It doesn't do a whole lot of damage, but it comes out really quickly. Can she link off of overhead? Yes. There. The X one is the real deal. The X one's the reason we're all here. The X one is the main reason to play Ibuki. It's really oh yeah, kunai super. I didn't mention that. I mentioned V trigger, but not super. Again, it's safe, and you can just super on reaction. Oh shit, does that work? Wait, charged MP release? Huh? Anyway. I gotta test this now. That can't combo, can it? Is that what you're talking about? I've never heard of this. Oh, I didn't even mention this. Oh, well, I'll talk about it when I talk about kunai Kanaga. EX kunai is the reason we're all here. EX kunai is the main reason to play Ibuki. It's fucking awesome. It's 100% safe. It's actually plus a fuck ton. If they block it. It costs a bar and it costs a kunai, which is the reason they felt like it was okay to make it the best special move in the whole game. On hit, it launches the opponent, gives you enough time to dash and get a juggle of some variety if you want to. And there's actually a bunch of juggles you can do there. I usually just do dash in Rida. That's like the main editor. But if you want to burn another kunai, you can do a command jump into a kunai toss. I'm not so hot with these, am I? Is it hard? Maybe I'm just doing it early. Yeah. There you go. There you go. I think that does a smidge more damage, but it costs a second kunai, and kunais are a valuable resource, so you don't usually see those. But it's really good for that little extra damage you need sometimes. You can also do uppercuts, I guess. And I think you can also do V skill. But you gotta be kind of close for that one. There you go. And V-Skill is a kind of cool under because it gives you some V-Bar, which Ibuki has kind of a hard time getting, especially because she's got a 3-bar V-Trigger. And it's also really good because you can V-Trigger cancel. Let me get this first bomb out of here. You can V-Trigger cancel that second... V-Trigger cancel after... You can do a V-Trigger cancel from that V-Skill, and it's a really good way to get that second bomb on the screen. It gives you a nice little Loki, especially in the corner, where you can do some second bomb mix-ups. It's like her only easy way to get a second bomb up from the first bomb, is V-Skill into that. But it also works from regular explosions, and it's not bad. Let me see here. What else about EX Kunai? I feel like there's still more stuff to say. I think even EX Kunai just gets stuffed by regular fireballs, though, so be really careful about fireballs. Ibuki does not have a clean answer. Oh, wait, that just went through. I lied. I'm a bad Ibuki player. Does that just clean go through? That's a super good trade. I thought that bounced off. Take it back. Ibuki's the best character in the game. Unfortunately, this is, like, you still gotta aim. You've got three different ranges of EX Kunai. It's light and medium for the really close one, which is the one you want almost all the time. Light and hard for the medium one, and medium and hard for the far one. And I guess this is probably a pretty good answer for fireballs, albeit you can't combo out of the explosion, and it's only 60 damage. So maybe not super good. You're not going to have a super either. Situationally, potentially useful. That's all I can say. There's a reason I've never seen it, is because doing anything from that is going to be difficult. Whatever, it's like a really good special move. It's really plus on block. It's a good combo, like starter. It's totally safe. Lets you get in if it's blocked. Whatever, it's like super good. The problem is it doesn't often combo from like light normals. Like I shut off the two jabs into that, but that's like literally the only one. And pretty much all of Ibuki's combos are into light normals, so you have a really hard time comboing into that in general. You basically gotta get like counter hit combos. Something like that. You gotta be really ready for counter hits as Ibuki. Otherwise you just gotta use it. Oh, it's a super good fishing pole. It's a super good empty cancel. If I'm doing like cancels into the light plus hard one, from like right here, or like even the light plus medium one from like right here, and I counter poke something, I can just cancel into the kunai and then get the walk in whatever. And you're risking a lot less when you're using like an empty cancel. But you still need a bar and a kunai to do it. But like this is probably like worth most of Ibuki's bar. Like pretty much all of her bar should go into this. She doesn't have that many EX special moves anyway, so. Spin kicks are gone. Neckbreaker's gone. Sorry everyone. What now? Kunai Ikinage, is it time? So, if you hold punch, like a zonk, and then release, she will throw all of her remaining kunai. How awesome that is depends on how many kunai you have. It's always scaled as one attack, regardless of how many kunai you throw. The ground one causes a struggle state, so you can just combo out of it. Point blank, you can do stuff like Raida, and that's actually really important for like her kill combos. That ends up doing like a ton of damage. Oh, she's 16. I think you need to... There you go, yeah. 351. Ouch. EX Kunai from light kick and block strings. Yeah, that's super good. It's not bad. It's still good to cancel into EX Kunai in general. It keeps you in, it keeps you plus, it keeps the mix-ups rolling even if it's blocked, and if it hits you can just reaction combo. EX Kunai is really strong. Anyway, light one just all goes in a line, and I think it's generally the easiest one to use in combos. They all hit properly. Like if you, they get kind of weird if you're hitting them. Why do I keep hitting that button? They get kind of weird if you're using the medium one. The medium one is tall. I don't know that many uses for this, like almost any. But I will say one that I've seen one time that I think is kind of neat. Kunai Ikinage is like neat. The special move. I saw some guy counter a fireball with a medium one, and the very very low kunai will go under the fireball. So he was just waiting for a fireball from this far away. He's like, fuck. He's waiting for a fireball from this far away, and as soon as he saw one, he's like, oh, how about that? And he just threw it like that and closed out the round. The very you can't do that with the normal one. You can't do that with regular kunai, and you can't do that with light kunai ikinaga. But you can do that with medium ikinaga. You can catch people's toes with the fireballs with the kunai. The hard one is pretty interesting. They go up in an arc. It's a super good anti-air. It'll anti-air like pretty much any jump in the universe, even like a full screen like neutral jump. You'll have a hard time actually hitting the opponent from that far out. But like if you're like if you've almost got the opponent dead, you can kind of sit on a hard punch, and then you see the opponent jump in, you can just toss this and it's gonna kill them. You know what I mean? It's like a huge range of effectiveness. There's no air mix up in the game that can get out of the way of that. There's no other Ibuki like air EX kunai. There's no instant EX dive kick. There's no good way to not eat a kunai there. Oh yeah, and you can get if you get an anti-air with it, you can juggle super, which is pretty chill. But it's kind of just a really good attack to sit on around closing. Ikinaga is just really good to do if you've got like an excess of kunai. The problem is they get shittier and shittier the less kunai you have. So like let's say I only have like 2 kunai. And I do kunai ikinaga. That doesn't do that much damage. It was 148. It's only like barely more than the fucking BP by itself. And I think they actually get really hard to like combo out of if you only got 1 kunai. Like, the more kunai you have, the easier it is. See, that like normally works, but it won't work if I don't have enough kunai because the opponent isn't getting hit for long enough. It should work into DP as long as you've got at least 1 kunai. It has different properties from a normal kunai throw, though. That's worth mentioning. It's super important. Is a regular kunai throw will never knock the opponent down. But even if you've only got 1 kunai, kunai ikinaga will still knock over. I'm pretty sure it super cancels too. Maybe not. It juggles anyway. The fact that it juggles is like super useful. I've closed out rounds like that. That's a super good post-Dizzy combo. Super good post-Dizzy combo. Anyway, it's punches on the ground. Charge, like a Zonk. But in the ground, it's kick. I mean, in the air, it's kicks. And you got, again, 3 different versions. The light one all travels in a pretty much a straight line. And again, you can do it from neutral jump and back jump. So if you've got an excess of kunai, you can actually do some really tricky stuff here. Where, like, you jump backwards and then see the opponent do certain things and then, like, toss the kunai at them. Why is this not working? You gotta pass the height limit. Funk. How spread out they are is based on which button you're holding, or rather the inverse. Medium one spreads out quite a lot, so you're probably not gonna. If you don't know where they're gonna be, it's more likely to hit them. But if you're probably gonna get fewer kunai to hit them overall. Hard and even more extreme of that. Hard is like a pretty good. Like you can jump over a fireball and do an instant kunai ikinaga in general, like with any version of this, and use that to punish fireballs, and that's actually like pretty good. And I think from those you can do like a land EX Raida. A nice little reaction confirm. I think you can't do like a lot of normal stuff. You won't usually have enough time. But EX Ride is pretty reliable here. There, I got dash in hard DP. Kunai Ikinaga is usually just like a lot of people don't really learn it because it takes a lot of. One, it's a Zonk and people hate Zonks, and two, it like wastes your one of your most precious resources, but it's like super it's actually pretty. It has a lot of really situational, really useful things that it does. I've talked about pretty much every kunai thing to talk about. She is really cool. She's got a lot of cool stuff she can do. I'm scratching the surface of this character, but this character is actually fairly deep. Okay, I didn't talk about the kunai reload at all, but I guess it's worth talking about just a little bit. Hold on. I just sneezed. Half circle back kick. She loots through her fucking invisible purse. Anklet thing. Not anklet, what do you call that thing? It's like a garter. Her kunai garter. She'll grab kunai off of it. How long you hold the button affects how many kunai you pull up. It's fairly easy to pull out 1 kunai just in footsies. Like, people won't usually punish this unless they're really watching for it. But be careful. You don't want to eat, like, a random, like, Laura medium elbow or something like that. Just because you're pulling out random kunai here and there. But it's usually not that hard to just get a kunai back if you really need one. If you've got like one bar and the opponent will die to an EX kunai combo and you're like out of kunai, you know, it might be a good idea to pull out just a random kunai. But that's the time when the opponent will most be looking for it. If you get certain knockdowns, you can get more. If you get like a dizzy, you could just, you know, pull out all of them. You usually won't, like, you start with full kunai, and you probably won't usually use them up that fast. So, like, you probably usually won't need to pull out more than like three at a time. And you don't need to hold that long to get three. I just got four. That's two. There you go, there's three. That's how long it takes to pull three out. Most of the, getting the kunai, most of that animation you just have to see no matter what. So, like, the difference between pulling out one kunai and two kunai is very negligible. So, like, if you're gonna go through the trouble of getting one, it's oftentimes not too difficult to get it two. But it is really unsafe. There's, like, no way to really guarantee this except for, like, EX Raida, Hard Raida, and EX kunai. It's not a bad idea to just ditch your punishes after like an EX kunai or whatever just to get some kunai back. Depends on where you are in the round and what kind of resources you need. If you have an excess of meter and you're out of kunai, then that kind of thing is something you'd want to do. That little reload she does, when her idle animation, she'll pull out a kunai and then kind of spin it around. She actually reloads a kunai for that. It's totally pointless. You'll never ever actually see that in a real match, an idle animation. But she does get a kunai back just for doing that. I think it's kind of cute. You know what I'd really like for Ibuki? You know what the change that would absolutely just sell me on this character 100% like I'd main her? Is if they made sweep cancel. I was thinking about that earlier today. I was like, imagine if they did that. Imagine if sweep was a cancel. Imagine if you could just cancel into sweep. I mean, from sweep. Imagine if you could just sweep kunai. It would make it so cool to like be able to, like, because like sweep into kunai on block would be like good pressure. And sweep into kunai on hit, the kunai would whiff, but you'd like, you could fish for crush counters more reliably. Throw range would be helpful. I'd actually want her to have more foot speed. She's already got really good foot speed, but I want it even faster. I want like SF4 Yang. I want to really zip around the screen. Her forward walk speed's so good, but her back walk speed is just a little lagging. I want her to really move. I want her to be fast. Because her range is so bad, you need to do so much walking in order to get stand strong, stand short to actually like to be close enough to combo. Like walking in and out of throw range with her, you've got to do like extra walking because her throw range is so shit. I think she's not that bad. A lot of people think she's, like, super mediocre. A lot of people call her, like, the secret worst character in the game, but I feel like there's actually quite a lot to this character, but I don't know if she's really... I don't know if she's got it in her to be top tier. I think she's just not that bad. Have I covered every special move? I think so. Slide, reach, trigger, cancel. I like that. That was the special moves. Yish. I've got the second bomb. Alright, so let's talk about super. There's not a whole lot to talk about. It is invincible. I think it is a low. Pretty sure it's a low. No, it's not actually a low. It's a pretend low. Doesn't matter anyway. Don't do it randomly. You can combo to it fairly easily. It cancels from DP. You've got to do the second hit cancel, so you do lose a hit of the DP, but it's not... You get most of the damage. DP into super is technically your most reliable way of landing super, because it doesn't use any kunai, and you might not have kunai. And it also does a lot more damage than kunai, but it does less damage than kunai ikinage, depending on how many kunai you have. So if you have a fuck ton of kunai, then that's technically your strongest way of going into it. But generally, DP into super is like a fairly common setup. It's pretty strong. It's not bad to land anytime you can land it. It will anti-air. I think you're better off doing back strong. It's not like a super reliable anti-air. You're better off doing back strong into... I think the opponent has to act. I don't think it actually hits them until they land. That might have been an anti-air. I don't know. I think they have to land. If they have to land, that means they can just empty jump and block it. But you could do this instead, which still works. So that's probably like your go-to anti-air combo for super. But it does pretty good damage, and it is invincible, so you can use it as like an invincible reversal, and it goes really far, and it goes through fireballs fairly easily. It's like her best fireball punish by far. I don't know if it'll catch Numbeck OS. Fuck, that is not a super. It works from really far away, especially for Ryu, who gets really wide when he throws fireballs. But, not that wide. I was trying to find the max range of it. You'd really want to do it from closer than this. Fuck. But you can do it from really close. Like, as soon as... Provided you can even react to the fireball, you know. It's a really good fireball punish from a lot of ranges. But that's like one of its uses. You can go through attacks. You can go through fireballs. You can technically combo into it from pretty much any juggle. The problem is most of her juggles come from EX Kunai, and that uses a bar, so you can't super. But if you get juggles from Ikinaga, or if you get juggles from Bomb, you can fairly easily land super. Describe invincible too, I guess. Yeah, if you want to, that's just all part of, like, you know, it's got the full body invincibility. And you can land it after, like, let's say I do like a bomb combo. I do something like this. I did forward dash. Forward dash just makes it more consistent. Kapow. It's a pretty good ender. Because minimum scaling and supers and whatnot. There's not a whole lot to say about it. Combo ender, and invincible tool. V-skill, I guess now. So V-skill's kind of neat. There's two different versions. You can charge it just a smidge, and it doesn't go very far. But it goes far enough and does okay damage. You can't combo anything from it except V-trigger. If you hold it, it does a bit more damage and gets a lot more range. And the thing about this is that Ibuki is not very good at having range. Like, her attacks just don't go very far. So the flat out of it, that's like the farthest one. But if you do V-skill, it like has actual good range, and she steps backward to do it. So like, in addition to having actual good range, if the opponent like tries to poke her, her hurtbox like actually physically moves back. So it's actually like a pretty good, annoying poke. It's just basically a poke. There's not a whole lot to say about V-skill. And you got two different charge versions. You can charge it very little or charge it a lot. The range goes up a little bit, but the startup gets worse. There's not a whole lot to say about that. I think they're both unsafe from really close. I think. I don't even know where the frame is on this bullshit. What's this called? What's the name of this thing? Tenrai. Tenrai is -5, the regular one. The fully charged one is -2. So if it's fully charged, it's safe. But again, she takes a big step back, so it's good for footsies. Whiff punishing and whatnot. It's a really good whiff punish. The startup is really poor, though. So you've got to use it. You've got to use it without regard to what the opponent's doing. You've got to use it to fish. You can't, like, you can't use it on reaction to a poke. You'll never whiff punish on reaction. You've got to, like, just, like, happen upon a whiff punish. But it's really good at that. But that's, like, the only thing it's really good for. It's really hard to use this against some characters with good range. It's really easy to use it against others. So, basically, in some matchups, you'll get a lot of it in some matchups. It builds V-trigger on block and hit, but not on whiff. So whiffing it does nothing. Let me verify that real fast. That was critical gauge. Yeah, whiffing does nothing. Gets quite a lot of V-meter. And let me have him block. Yeah, still builds quite a lot of V-meter on block. I see it a lot against Laura. Zangief, I'm not surprised at all. That seems like a character I'd be really good against. I felt it a lot as Laura. It does cancel to V-trigger. Oh, I should mention this right now. Because it builds V-meter, if you're really trying to get that last little bit of V-meter, or just in general over the course of the round, this is one of your possible enders after like an EX Kunai, after, dare I say it, a Kunai Ikinaga. No, that doesn't work. I don't think you have time to charge even the short one. But EX Kunai for sure. No, you can't get the short one. And what else? What's the other one? What's my other launcher? Bomb. You don't get V-meter if you throw a bomb and juggle out of the bomb. But if you juggle into this, fuck. What's the setup? I'll do the Rider setup. No, that's even harder. What the fuck is the setup? Is it full charge from that far away? I think that might be it. No. There's forward walking and it's no charge, I think. Yeah, there you go. It's a forward dash, no charge. You can juggle into blast, and then from that blast you can get your second bomb off before they even recover their character, and then that second bomb can lead to nice things. I've mentioned that so many times now, I feel like, over different parts of this video. Let's talk about V-trigger. This is a super hard trigger to talk about. So there's a bomb. She tosses one. That's the short fuse. Forward is the really, really long fuse. And backward is the medium length fuse. I don't know a reason to put the really long fuse on the screen. That one's not super useful, I don't think. I guess it causes a lot of danger, but usually you want the neutral one or the back one. This is, you know, otherwise. The cool thing about the bomb is both players can kind of push it around. Usually you won't see the other guy even bother to try and touch it, because the bomb, the explosion hurts only the opponent, never Ibuki. But you can see some kind of cool combos where people kind of just push it all over the place. It's kind of funny looking. Danger. Hold on, I'm gonna play some Tekken Ball. Oh damn it, I tried to do the tower combo. Does that work? Can you cancel off of this hits that hit the bomb? God damn it, I keep on throwing the short one. I can't even, what do I even hit that with? There you go. Alright, that looked like a cancel. I'm doing something incredibly stupid. Like kick, medium kick roundhouse. Oh yeah, there you go. There's a okay, I'll give it a go. Does that really work? Oh my god. That was cool. That is bomb juggle swag, dog. You can, if the opponent walks out of the range of the bomb and it's like a long fuse bomb, you can kind of push the bomb closer to them just by hitting it. Ibuki will always like attack towards the opponent and her attacks will throw the bomb towards the opponent. So you can kind of keep the pressure on them even if they're holding backwards just by pushing the bomb along. But when it's on the ground, you can only hit it with like light kick and crouch light kick and like slide and like, you know, not that many attacks. But if you launch it in the air, you can kind of push it around a little bit. There's a little bit of a strategy to that. The bomb is pretty neat. It's actually OTGs. I'm gonna have a hard time demonstrating this. A really hard time demonstrating this. I have him on quickstand. It'll like it's like super frame precise. To OTG on quickstand. Like that. That actually comboed. That throw is like super precise to time. This is misfortune. If they don't quickstand, it's easy as fuck. I don't know why I did it like that. Alright, hold on. Let me do a back bomb. Alright, I don't know the timing. Yeah. Not very hard to time at all. And you can combo out of that. You can combo throw to bomb to, like, Ryda, for example, on a cornered opponent. Huh? Oh, it's because the bomb is flying. For example. That's really precise to do, but like if you know the timings of like the bomb and then the throw, it's not very hard to get. And then from it is pretty hard to get, but like you can it's feasible in a real match, is what I'm trying to say. The bomb explosion has basically gotta be going on as you toss him into it. Pretty cool little combo though. Anyway, the bomb explosion is kind of big, and you can use it to... There's a lot of things that Ibuki can do to force the opponent to get hit by the bomb. So, like, for example, I was doing, like, throw into bomb explosion, but another way you can do it is a dash through right before the bomb explodes. That's, like, one I showed off earlier. That. I just reset Ryu. That actually comboed. I didn't mean for it to combo. Alright, there you go. I got a reset and then the bomb explosion. The bomb explosion didn't combo, so like he suddenly had a new blocking direction and the bomb hit him almost as soon as he had a new blocking direction. There, the recovery of my slide, my command dash didn't matter because it wasn't me that was hitting him, it was the bomb that was hitting him. So that was safe, and it was a lot harder to react to because I didn't have to resolve my own recovery. So it's really tricky to... there's a lot of ways you can do it with the low overhead mix-up with like low short and jump short, or like, you know, her really, really slow overhead. You can do it, you can overhead during the bomb. That's a super nice thing. I did it really early. But like, let's say there's a bomb explosion going on. I don't know. The setups. Take my word for it. Like that. That's probably where you use that overhead. Um, He's not blocking, which is making it a lot harder to show off anything. You can use low overhead mix-ups to land the bomb. You can use left-right mix-ups to land the bomb. You could even use those to land the bomb. Okay, the bomb is, like, pretty... There's a lot of sneaky ways to land it. Unfortunately, it's kind of hard to use those sneaky ways to land it because the bomb takes a really long time to explode and won't explode until it's ready. There's no way to make it explode immediately. And the opponent can just get the fuck out of the way. But maybe that's the mix-up, you know what I mean? Maybe the opponent's like, ah, I don't want to be standing on this bomb. I'm going to hold up forward, and then you, like, anti-air them. You get the idea. The opponent has to take a risk to get out of the way of that bomb, and they take a risk by standing in the way of that bomb. The bomb is blockable. It's not, like, unblockable or anything like that. But it guarantees you free pressure even if they just block it. Like, you still get, like, the, you know, the mix-up. You get the approach. You get the frame trap. You get whatever you want. Pookie is the bomb. There's a lot to say about the bomb, and I'm, like, not really sure what all to say about it. Are they going to fix Ibuki's face? She looks really childlike in this game, doesn't she? Ugh, I'm running out of shit to say. I don't want to keep talking about the V-trigger, even though there's, like, more to say. Oh, let me talk about this. This is really important. So, the first V-trigger, it works like Yurian and a few other characters. The first V-trigger freezes the screen to toss the bomb. The second V-trigger does not freeze the screen to toss the bomb. This has radically different implications on our combos. Like, I've been doing Stand Fierce, like Kunai into Stand Fierce. That combos, because of the screen freeze. But if I do a second bomb toss, that's never going to combo in a million years. It's way too slow. So the second bomb is a lot harder to use as a combo tool than the first one. Whoa, a bomb exploded by EX Kunai does more damage than the sum of an EX Kunai and bomb. I did not know that. That's crazy. That must be individually programmed. 60 for that. 100 for that. Alright, my body's ready. Oh my, wait, yeah, 195. How about that, dude? Interesting. That's weird as fuck. I didn't know that. I knew you could explode the bomb with the kunai. I said there's no way to detonate it, but you can detonate it with an EX kunai, even if it's like the really long fuse. Kablam. That's weird. I didn't know that. That's cool. Anyway, what was I saying? Shit, I had like something important. Oh yeah, the first bomb is fairly easy to combo. Like, just I've been doing kunai, because kunai makes it easier. But you can actually just throw a bomb. And then you can do like... Pretty sure this works, right? No, that doesn't work. But you can do this. That's a kunai-less combo. So if you don't have kunai, you can still do stuff. But it's a lot harder. Depends on what you're trying to do. If you do have a kunai, the hit stun is super long. So you can fairly easily combo various things. What else? Oh, but like the second bomb, like the only way to really reliably combo into the bomb with second bomb, let me toss my first bomb and set it to infinite timer. The second bomb, you pretty much gotta land an EX Kunai to reliably combo into the second bomb. Like, there's no other way to use second bomb and have it combo than EX Kunai. But if you use EX Kunai, the combo is pretty much EX Kunai canceled to bomb. Looks like that. And then that's still not enough time, so you've got a combo out of the EX Kunai. Like that. Looks really weird. But it's like the combo I'm doing is low strong EX Kunai, bomb, dash in, Ryda, command dash Ryda. That was bad. That works. I'm just bad. I'm out of kunai. I'm doing a walk-in here instead of a dash-in. It depends on which one you'd want is based on how far away you are from the opponent, because the Ryda can't hit the bomb, and it affects the timing of the combo. Maybe just DP there. I don't remember this being that hard. Fuck. There you go, I got him. That's like your best way of confirming the second bomb. That's like your only way of confirming the second bomb. But from the first bomb, there's a lot of other stuff you can do to be sneaky. Now what? Are we done? Let's talk about combos. Anti-airs and combos. Anti-air, crouch fierce, pretty good. Anti-air, hard kick, pretty good. Anti-air, back strong, pretty damaging. Not super good though. Can those struggles work with a critical art editor? Yes. Not the EXQ9 ones. Proof of concept. Proof of concept. I did one of these earlier in the video. I did a super, super early, but like, you should do it later. But it still worked. But you should do it later. Bread and butter punish combo would probably be something really baby, like Jab Strong Fierce Uppercut or Jab Strong Fierce Raida. That doesn't do a whole lot of damage, but Ibuki doesn't do a whole lot of damage. So get used to it. I think Crouch Fierce does a smidge more damage. Yeah, that did 198. A little bit more. What else? That's like her bread and butter from a 3-frame starter, and also her bread and butter in general. Bread and butter from an overhead is like that. Bread and butter from a low, it's like that. You can do these or this, depending on which one happens. Had a heavy kick air dash, can I? Yeah. I didn't even show that off. It's more of a second bomb combo. When you get the bomb explosion, oh god, I don't know the setup from my setup. Like that, I guess. Alright, hold on. I know exactly how I would do this. I'm pretty sure that works. I might have been late. I don't remember if that works after DP or if you have to do Raida into that. Fuck, I got a regular ass kunai. I didn't get the command jump. Fuck, I got the attack. I think it adds damage to do the kunai, but it's like less than 20 damage. It's like 20 scaled damage, which is basically less than the cost of the kunai. I prefer to save kunai. Let me see here. Let me get this once. There you go. Eureka. I don't think that does like any more damage. It's cool looking. It's super cool looking. What other combos? Strong, short, DP, very standard confirm combo. If you get counter hit, you can do strong, low, strong, DP, but I can't do that without counter hit. You can combo to, if it's counter hit, you can do EX Kunai instead of, if it's low, strong, you can do EX Kunai instead. Comboing into EX Kunai is basically just a crapshoot. You don't have that many things that set up EX Kunai. You've got Jab Strong Fierce sets up EX Kunai. You've got, just individual buttons. It's safe, so you can just do it. You can do individual buttons into it and just fish like that, but hit confirming it is kind of more difficult. As a hit confirm EX Kunai. Why is she not one of the better characters in the game? 900 health, that's the main reason. There's no reason more important than that. If she was 1,000 or even 950, she'd be fairly good. But 900 health sucks, especially when you have a 3-bar V-trigger. It's very easy to die without getting V-trigger. Also, I didn't mention this at all, and I should mention it at some point or another, but she's got a very interesting V-reversal, which unfortunately, you either have the V-reversal or you have the bomb, but you don't really have both, because 4 bars on a character that builds V-meter, not very well at all. It's 4 plus kicks, right? Or is it 4 plus punches? No, I'm not sure. Oh, fuck, it is 4 plus punches. The log is the thing that hits. But she'll actually teleport to the opponent when she does it, which is kind of surprising and sneaky. If you do it from up close, it's just your regular-ass normal V-verse. 60 damage knocks down, damage is dealt in white health. That's, like, totally standard. It'll do that from, like, a bunch of all the normal ranges where normal V-reversals will hit. But if you do it from really far away, she'll, like, teleport to the opponent. It, like, tracks the opponent. And a lot of people don't really know that, so you can kind of maybe... It's got kind of a lot of recovery, but you can probably surprise people to some degree. Yeah, her scaling is pretty bad, too, and she doesn't have that many setups. I mean, she has a lot of setups, but she doesn't have that many, like... A lot of her combos just aren't very strong. They just go through, like, medium and light almost. They were very careful about giving her a medium to medium link, because it would give her, like, a reactable EX Kunai link. But by not giving her that, they basically, like, didn't give her, like, any sort of meaningful anything from confirms. She's really weird. She uses tarot combos to do what a lot of other characters can just do through, like, their own, like, you know, timing and spacing. I've, like, run out of things to say for Ibuki, even though there's a lot to say. I've run out.